The fifth upper keyboard section is actually labelled up as extra voice. Now, we can either load a standard sound in here to give us a fifth layer, or we can use a VST or a virtual instrument. And as standard in the Bemore Genesis, the VB3 drawbar module is loaded as a VST. So if I switch on the VST button over here, you will see that in the center of the screen now becomes a virtual Hammond drawbar module. And as you can see, as I move the physical drawbars, it responds to the drawbars on the screen, exactly the same on the lower manual as well. We have all the controls like percussion attack, rotary speaker, etc. So we have an actual virtual Hammond organ built in there as well. And that enables us to create classic sounds, a little bit like this one.
So the first part of the screen we're going to look at is how we control the styles. Now the beauty of the Bemore is that you're able to load styles from Yamaha, Ketron, Korg and Roland products. So the beauty of this style section in the Bemore is that actually you can create your own style section with all your favourite styles from all those different manufacturers' instruments. And I've chosen a style here called Lovely Waltz. We can see the name of the style printed clearly up at the top. I can see the tempo is 86 and I can see it's registering a 3/4 time signature because we're on a waltz. Now, on the left hand side here, we can see all the different sounds that are used in all the five accompaniment parts. That's if they're all being used. Some styles may only use three parts, some may use four, etc. But on this one, we've got all five parts being used. We've got the bass, and we have the two drum parts. Let's just have a listen to the intro, see how it sounds. So there you go, there's nothing wrong with that at all. You probably noticed along the top the blue bar underneath where it says Lovely Waltz, when we played the intro, actually begins to turn white. That actually is a progress bar for the intro, works exactly the same on the ending as well. you know, I think we've all been caught out by not knowing when an intro is coming to an end. Well, as the white progress bar comes across, you can actually see once that intro is coming to an end and it's time for you to do your bit. Next time, when I revoice this in a second and we redo the intro, maybe you have a look at that progress bar and you'll see it in action. So I'm going to quickly show you how I can revoice this to make yet another style. I'm going to change the strings in accompaniment 3. So I choose accompaniment 3, and that little rectangle there goes light grey. At the moment it's showing general MIDI slow strings. I'm already on the strings button over in the sound selector, so I'm just going to page through to page 7. I'm going to choose a sound called Smooth Full Strings. As soon as I press it, you'll see it load up into the accompaniment 3 slot, just there. Now, if you wanted to adjust the volume, if we move the volume control for accompaniment 3, we can see we can actually set the volume of that as well. The other thing I'm going to change is the drum kit down at the bottom. It's on a standard drum kit at the moment. Again, I'm going to scroll through, this time to page 3. And I'm going to use a jazz brush kit because I think the brushes will sound much nicer on that waltz rhythm. So there you go. We've very simply revoiced the style. Let's have a listen to the intro again. Pay particular attention to the strings now, which I think are a much fuller, richer sound. You'll hear the brush kit and have a look for that little progress bar as we listen to the intro again of Lovely Waltz.